Welcome to People. I'm Shirley Lin. Today, I'm really honored to have Lin Hsiu-wei as my guest on my show. Well, she is the producer of Contemporary Legend Theater, and she's the founder of Taigu Tales Dance Theater. Well, let's welcome Hsiu-wei.
Hello, everybody.
All right, thank you so much for coming. But I want everybody to know first that if you've heard of Cloud Gate Dance Troupe, then Hsiu-wei happens to be a dancer of that prestigious dance group before she started her own dance troupe. So how long were you with Cloud Gate?
10 years.
10 years,
so yeah. I was leading dancer and choreographer and rehearsal master.
Wow.
For 10 years, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. See, I think I really admire, you know, Hsiu-wei's character and personality because she loves taking on these big roles, right?
Yeah.
You know, important roles in a dance troupe. Mm-hmm. Well, after all, I mean, I really want you to tell our listeners, you know, or our audience, just your love story with Wu Hsing-kuo, who is her husband, but also
he
a
was
former
a Cloud Gate dancer
also. As well.
Yeah,
yeah.
I met him in Cloud Gate.
Right,
yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. You want to go tell us, you know, what happened in the beginning? Because he was like new to the group, and he was very handsome,
yes,
and dark looking,
yeah.
And you fell in love
with
him.
He's very talented, yeah, also.
Right,
yeah.
And you fell in love with him right away.
Yeah, when I saw him, the first eyes, I said, yeah, that is the man I want to fall in love with him, yeah.
Right,
yeah.
So, but then I think there was a chance to dance together.
Yes.
And of course, actually before that, you were hoping to kind of play the, you know, the leading role in that dance number
with
him.
That is the year, I think it's when I was 17 years old.
You were only 17 then?
Yeah.
And how old was he?
He's older, he's 3 years older than me.
Oh, so he
so
was 20.
Yes, he's very charming, so many ladies love him, so I need
know.
To chase so, him, yeah.
But it never crossed your mind to think that, oh, I don't have a chance. Did you think that, not me, I, you know, he's probably going to fall in love with other women better than me or something like that. Did you ever think that?
No, because, you know, my character is, I have very big passion, you know, and I think never thing can stop me if I want it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, that's what I admire about you, Hsiu-wei, is just your fighting spirit, you know?
Right.
You're willing to do anything to get what you want.
The difficult for me, just like a stone, you know, you just need to jump in over the stone, you know?
Right.
When you was young, you maybe you jump in the small stone, but maybe small stone become a big mountain. You should need, like a dancer, you know, you need to jump in upon the all those difficulties. Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. It's just amazing because apparently you did have a chance to dance with him, the lead role. I think it was the White Serpent.
Yes, I played Green Serpent.
Yeah, and you played Green Serpent. Now, that's a very classic, you know, performance. And I think something like there was another teacher, actually, Lin Huaimin, who's the founder of a Cloud Gate dance troupe, I think he sprained his ankle or something. So he said, Wu Hsing-kuo, why don't you dance for me? And Hsiu-wei, you dance with him.
Yeah.
And then even though you're waiting for this chance to dance with him, you were very shy.
Yeah, right.
You were very shy.
Because this is my first performance to dance that role. And I dream about that many, many days, many, many months.
Months.
You know? And to dream about how romantic when I first danced with him.
Yeah.
But it happened suddenly. It's in Sun Yat-sen Memorial Hall.
Yes.
It's a big theater.
Yeah.
Over 2,000 people. So I was so nervous because I never got any chance to practice with him.
Right.
Before. So
yeah,
suddenly
a formal performance. Yeah.
Yeah. So suddenly we danced together, and it's so successful. So after that we have a celebration, and because I was so young, so I drink a lot of cocktail, and I thought it's a juice, so I drank, you know, I sat him on the chair, and Wu Hsing-kuo said, can I send you home?
Right.
Yeah, that's the love story to start.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you said no.
Yeah.
But then he says, no, let me drive you home.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
And that's how your love story started.
Right. Yeah.
So after
it's
that,
motorcycle.
A motorcycle.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So, so you had more and more opportunities to dance the lead roles with him after
because of that successful performance, we tour around the world,
yeah,
and so it's very beautiful memory, you know, to States, so Europe, you know, we grew up together,
and
crying together and holding each other, so.
Crying, I mean, in a sad way, or
sad, sometimes you're happy because everything's so successful,
yeah.
But sometimes you feel very painful because maybe you were hurt from your work, you know. Mm-hmm. So we always give each other for very strong love to each other,
yeah.
because after Cloudgate, I have my own dance company. He has his own drama company.
Yes,
it's so difficult to have two companies. You know?
Right.
And especially the opera company, the Contemporary Legend Theater, mm-hmm. because it's based on Beijing opera.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes, because it's based on tradition. And tradition is very very difficult to find the young person to join us.
So, right.
Yeah, to find the budget also, yeah. to mm-hmm. find the support. So mm-hmm. That's why we grow up with those painful and joy and happiness, yeah.
Well, before we go on to talk about both of your theater groups that you've started, and you and your husband, I do want to say that, you know, you guys have a very romantic love story, and I think it should be made into a movie.
Yeah.
It really should be made into a Hollywood movie.
Oh,
you
really?
Know, seriously. Mm-hmm. It's just so, you know, it's just a very catching story. Mm-hmm. Anyway. Mm. Now, so you were saying that right after Cloudgate, mm-hmm. so you were with Cloudgate for 10 years. Mm-hmm. Did you start your own company right away?
No, because I remember the last performance I was in Cloudgate is we have tour in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
And when I sitting in front of the mirrors, I'm making the makeup with the white serpent.
Uh-huh.
And I feel very... very sad because when I painted my eyes,
yes,
and my face,
yeah,
I think that this is my last performance.
Oh.
Dance with this character. You know,
how could you dance when you're feeling that sadness?
Yeah, because it's repeated. You know,
yeah.
The date, repeat and repeat, and I dance the same character.
Yeah,
yeah. So I want to be myself. I want to find my body language. And because since my mother told me, since I was born, I never stopped dance. And I still, my whole childhood, the whole memory is dance.
Yeah.
And I remember when I stretched my leg standing upon the floor, I can feel the temperature of the ground. I can feel the air when I breathe in, uh-huh. I can feel my heartbeat, how exciting is the nature. Yeah. So, but when I become a professional dancer, I think I lost that kind of spiritual. So when I'm painting that face, I say, that's enough. I need to find what is my nature, what is my language. So I said to my teacher, Lin Hsiu-wei, this is my last performance.
Yeah.
Yeah. So everybody just very, very
sad.
Shocked. Yeah. So after that, I have a chance to be as an international choreographer in South Carolina. It's an America Dance Festival.
Okay.
Yeah. So I took the 6-week class with many of the fantastic
dancers,
yeah, fantastic choreographer and
yes.
top dancer, and they all told me, they say, you should back to Taiwan, you should have your own company.
Wow.
Yeah, so after that, I back to Taiwan. I create a Taiko Tears Dance Company until now.
Oh. How did you come up with that name?
Taiko Tear.
It's like a space. Okay.
The space.
All right.
Eternity space.
Oh.
Yeah. It's very wide.
Yes.
The space is including your small universe and a huge universe.
That means your imagination can go on forever and ever for eternity.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Your body and nature's body.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that is beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the gu is timing.
Okay.
The timing. When you move, the time move with you.
Uh-huh.
So it's very historical. You know, it's like a culture memory or your life memory.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And the ta, it means your foot, you know.
Yeah. I was thinking about tap dancing.
Yeah. No, ta, but the left side is your foot. Yeah.
Right.
And the right side, upon the upon is the water and the sun. So you dance with the water and the sun. Yeah.
That was smart.
Yeah.
I never thought it that way. Wow, that is really good.
Yeah.
What do you think is the main theme or, principle behind your dance group, your dance theater? What's the main theme or, you know, principle you want to follow with your dance group?
You mean the body language or the spiritual?
Yeah. What do you want people to know
theatrical.
About Taiko Tales?
The theatrical, the East theatrical.
So it's not just dance; it's also theater and dance
mixed
in.
Searching, what's meaning of the life?
Okay.
And because my body is, I'm a woman, I'm a mother, mother, so I would like to send a lot of the love to the people.
Oh.
So I would like to, not just only for the ideas, to create some new idea. And I know many young choreographers, they always want to search in a new idea. But for me, I would like to send about the love, you know, from people to people, or from the nature, for the nature, for the people, for the nature. To search in the your soul.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's what
that
I think.
Is, you know, love is a very profound word.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it can mean a lot of things. And I think it's so beautiful. Mm-hmm. And you can express it in different ways about love.
Because sometimes, because the time's running too fast.
Yeah.
And the society, whole society.
Yes.
It changed very quick.
Right.
People, the young people doesn't want to read the 哲学,
philosophy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So I think what is the truth, you know, about the life for and about a human being.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes I will send the freedom and the peaceful sign to my audience.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That is great. Mm-hmm. And, you know, seeing the way you express and your hair, you know, it's such a...
I always use my hair like a wing and a tree.
Yes, you do.
And
you
a
do.
Wave.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. And that means a lot, you know.
It's a just... mystery. You know, for us, it's a mystery. So Wu Hsing-kuo say, don't cut your hair. Your hair belongs, it's part of my love, you know.
I would have said the same thing.
Yeah.
It just means so much. It plays such a big part in your dance and in the way you want to express, you know, what you want to express through the dance, you know. So,
but in our age, many of the dancers, they have long hair.
Yeah.
But not now.
Not now, huh?
Yeah, because not now everybody cuts the hair.
Because it's easier to take care of shorter hair, you know.
No, because it's more contemporary.
I see.
Yeah, this is tradition, I think.
Yeah, that is true. Mm-hmm. But I'm glad that you and Hsing-kuo are preserving all that classic and history about this form of art, you know, and never give up.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And pass it on mm-hmm. down, because otherwise it's going to be lost.
Mm-hmm.
And so I really think that it's great about what you guys are doing. I know it's tough. It really is tough. Mm-hmm. Who started your dance company first, your husband or you?
Me.
Oh.
But he is the first dancer.
Yeah.
Our first dance is a duet. Yeah, for the whole performance.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to talk more about Hsiu-wei and Hsing-kuo's, you know, hard work at their dance trips a little after this. So let's take a break here. Welcome back to People. I'm Shirley Lin. Today my guest is Lin Hsiu-wei, who's the founder of Taiku Tales Dance Theater and also the producer of Contemporary Legend Theater. Well, Hsiu-wei, mm-hmm. let's talk about, if we may, talk about this company that your husband started,
mm-hmm.
the Contemporary Legend Theater.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know that you work very hard to combine Western art with Beijing Opera.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah. He is a Beijing Opera actor.
Mm-hmm.
And when he was 10 years old, he training by Fuxing Opera School.
Okay.
Until it's at least the basic training is 8 years.
Mm.
And after that, he graduated from the high school of the Fuxing Opera School, and he studied in the Cultural University,
mm.
Chinese Cultural University. That is the chance who find him to join and to invite him to join Cloud Gate.
Yes.
And after the Cloud Gate, he back to the opera company.
Mm-hmm.
And when he back to the opera company, he find it's not so many audience.
Okay.
And the audience getting old.
Right. It's kind of dying, this art form.
Uh-huh. And but he still have some young people like to see him perform.
I do think so. Yeah, there are still some young people who like that kind of
so they
things.
Talk about that.
Okay.
And how you facing your fate, you know, your future.
Yeah.
So they encourage him to create some new things.
Okay.
So he make many calls, phone calls,
yeah.
to his friend,
uh-huh.
Including Wei Haiming,
oh,
who is
okay.
very family actress.
Yes.
She's during that time, she's only 26, 25.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So they started to meet together.
Mm-hmm.
But I married him very early. When I marry him, I'm 22 years old only.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. So they have a meeting with my home, my house.
Okay.
And I cook the food
yeah.
for them, yeah,
yeah,
when they make the meeting.
Mm.
So I hear, what they want.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So they decided to adapt Shakespeare and Macbeth.
Wow.
Yeah. So they write the script by themselves.
Yes.
The young people, they practice the dance. No, the drama.
Oh, the drama itself. Yes.
In the outdoor.
Okay.
And so the young, the hip hop dancer, they always dancing outdoor outside, right?
Oh, already
like a
at that time.
Yeah,
it was you making modern using hip hop.
No, not with the hip hop. I say, when they practice,
okay.
they are rehearsal.
Yeah.
They rehearsal in the park.
Oh, all right,
yeah,
all right. Yeah.
Like young people.
The young people. Oh.
Yeah, for 3 years.
Oh, wow.
And after that, they say, we need to have a money, we need to have supporting. And so they say, maybe you can do that.
So you're saying at that time, those 3 years was just practicing?
Yeah,
no practice. Formal performance?
No.
Oh, how tough.
Yeah, right. And nobody got any pay.
Mm.
So we have 30 uh-huh. young people from 17 years old
mm-hmm.
to 30, So I say, yes, maybe I can try it. I can try to find the money for you. But
yeah.
I never find, during that time, I just dance in the Cloud Gate. I just a dancer.
Oh, I see. You were still with cloud gate.
Yeah.
But then you're in your mind, you're thinking about
I can do that.
You're thinking you can do it.
Yeah, because I thought how Lin Huaming do that. So I said, maybe I can try that.
Okay.
Yeah. So then I do that. Then mm-hmm. I find the money, I find a theater, and we find the costume designer who provide the money to us.
How many years ago was
this? 1986.
1986.
So that's 25 years before.
Yes.
And when we perform in Taipei, it certainly is a huge success.
Success.
And in 1990, the Royal National Theatre in London.
London, yes. Yeah,
they invite us to perform for performances. It got huge success.
Mm-hmm.
So company open, you know, very big future.
Oh.
Yeah. So until now, my best, we yes. call the Kingdom of Desire,
uh-huh.
still perform last year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and we own the original actor.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they still play together. Even mm-hmm. we don't have any contract with them, but mm-hmm. I think our contract is in the heart. In the heart, yeah.
That is incredible.
Yeah.
How did you decide on Macbeth as the very first
mm-hmm. performance? Because Wu Hsing-kuo, he is a Wu Sheng. He's a main character. His okay. role is Wu Sheng. It's uh-huh. a fighting role.
Okay.
And Macbeth, who is a general. So I think this is very good. Not, that's why he didn't play a King Lear first.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Because he kept getting old. So he played King Lear 2,000 years. Yeah, right. In 2,000 years right. after that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so you think about those factors. You take those factors into consideration.
Mm-hmm.
So what about the costume? They're incredible costume.
Yeah. Who
did you find to help you with that?
She is a costume designer for cloud gate for a long time.
Oh, I see.
So it's an old friend, you know.
Oh.
It's a very deep friend around you, working mm-hmm. around you. Even the set designer, we met him. Deng Kunyan, we met him in karaoke also.
Oh, I see.
So they all jumping up.
Yeah.
Because they hear our idea.
They hear about your success.
No. Before that.
Oh, before.
The very first performance.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, right. The Kingdom Desire.
So I think they also see the future in this. You know, they support you.
No, I don't think they think that much. They just think.
It's interesting things. Oh.
And they want to join.
Yes.
This journey.
Yeah, wow. This journey.
Yeah, it's a journey.
Yeah.
So everybody just feel very interesting. Uh-huh. And they think it's a journey. It's a revolution. And we should join that revolution. Yeah.
Yes.
So
use the right word. Revolution. Yeah. It was really a revolution in Chinese art.
But Wu Hsing-kuo hanging a big pressure from the traditional war, you know, because the teachers say you shouldn't change any tradition. So you will kill, you will murder the tradition.
Uh-huh.
So it's very hard time for him also. And uh-huh. after the Kingdom of Desire, even audience like it. Even in the London, we got big successful.
Yes.
But after that, still very difficult because mm-hmm. always has one power.
Right.
They are against you.
Right. There's always the part that criticizes.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So for us, it's very, very difficult time for 10 years.
10 years?
Yeah, right.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
But you persevered. You did not give up. You and Hsing-kuo did not give up.
Yeah.
And that was the right thing to do.
So we are very lucky because many of the country, they invite us to mm-hmm. touring around the world. That is make us strong.
Mm.
Yeah, like Hou Hsiao-hsien or Cai Ming-liang.
Yes, which are some prestigious movie directors in Taiwan.
Right. Yeah, because they are very successful in a foreign country. So that's why Taiwanese think, maybe they are good, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the Wu Hsing-kuo, he's always my idol.
Because even to this day.
Yeah, he always try new. He always don't want to repeat himself.
Yeah.
And he's always challenging himself. Mm-hmm. That's why his works, he make new piece. When he make a new piece, he always want to, you know, jumping up to the last one.
Uh-huh.
So he wants 100% perfect.
Oh yeah.
Perfect. Yeah.
As all artists do.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. How about the makeup? Did you think of the makeup?
Mm-hmm. The makeup, you know, Chinese Peking opera makeup is very, very beautiful.
Yes.
But we don't want to repeat that the old fashion.
So okay.
We always invite the wonderful designer like Tim Ye,
uh-huh.
Ye Jingtian,
yes.
Wo Hu Changlong, who's uh-huh. Oscar winner.
Oh, yes, okay.
Yeah.
For the movie Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, yes.
Yeah.
Makeup designer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Huang Wenyin, who win the Jin Ma Jiang.
Oh.
She make a Hai Shang Hua, Beijing Chengshi, I think,
oh,
maybe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All these Chinese classics, okay.
Yeah, so we're very lucky, we always has very strong talented artists join us.
Mm.
Yeah, so that's why make the costume is very unique.
Mm-hmm.
And a little bit fashion.
You have to keep yeah. up with the young people, right?
Yeah, yeah. The hairstyle. We're very concerned about the hairstyle.
Oh, really?
And makeup style and costume form. Because Wu Hsing-kuo think the most beautiful costume is in Beijing opera.
Ah.
But you must across.
Mm.
You must, you can compare that kind of quality.
Yes.
So we spend a lot of the budget to create.
Try different things.
To create the Lost Beautiful.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Sometimes one costume, like the Tempest. The
Tempest.
Yeah, the main character.
Yes.
Prospero.
Mm-hmm.
Is a magic master, uh-huh. Prospero. Team Yet create the costume
yes.
for the Prospero.
Right.
It's very, very difficult costume, and we made that for 3 months.
Oh,
months.
Just yeah. that alone.
Yeah.
Spent
right.
3 months making
so
it.
So every costume for us is like an art.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can exhibition maybe in our celebration.
Right.
Okay, anniversary. Yeah.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Well, I understand that recently you guys just came back from the Edinburgh Drama Festival, was it?
Or no, is
it
International Festival.
International Festival.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, festival. And it was the first time that a Taiwanese dance troupe mm-hmm. was invited in 65 years of its history.
No, theater group. Yes,
theater group.
Yeah,
theater group. Okay. Yeah. In 65 years of its history.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite an honor.
Yeah, right. We got huge successful,
yeah,
and the newspaper give us
very
four, star.
Uh-huh. four star, 4 star,
yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. And the director said, if I need to choose only one group, or one show, yeah. I only choose Contemporary Legend Theater and King
Lear.
Yeah,
is this an annual festival? Like they have it every year?
Do they? Yeah. But
so.
It's a hundreds company.
Oh, I'm sure.
In the outdoor, but only maybe 10 company can invite it in the indoor.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So we are perform in the old theater, very beautiful theater.
Oh.
It's over 100 years.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. Mm. So you think you're going to be invited back again next year?
We hope so.
Okay.
But it's not easy,
yeah.
because many of the company they want to mm-hmm. get into it.
Yeah, sure.
On the name, yeah.
yeah.
And we because the Edinburgh, we got the 5 invitation next year.
Really?
To many different countries like Australia,
congratulations.
American, Italian, many countries.
Oh
yeah.
wow!
And
you're
France,
gonna be
yeah.
busy next year.
Every year is
always
very busy. Yeah.
Now the newest thing that I've discovered is mm-hmm. that you have come up with this hip hopera,
yeah.
which is hip hop plus opera.
Yeah, right.
Please, this is so interesting. You have the people mm-hmm. wearing miniskirts and leather jackets, mm-hmm. but performing using Beijing opera.
Yeah,
is that
they
right?
play eight traditional repertoire.
Uh-huh.
Eight plays.
Wow.
And only two character, only two actor. The one is an actor, one is an actress.
Yes.
They are young. Uh-huh. They play 22 character.
Oh my goodness.
Doing 2 hours.
Yeah.
So they need to change the movement and the singing and the dancing and the acting and the costume and the makeup suddenly in wow. front of the audience.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, the second part, they invite the audience play with them.
Uh-huh.
So it's very good relationship with the audience.
Audience.
Yeah.
Wow, that is such an original idea. Mm-hmm. That's really awesome.
That's from Wu Hsing-kuo.
Oh, I was just going to ask. So it's from your husband again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That is so exciting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I couldn't imagine what that's like. But thank you so much. It's been a great time listening to you hear your mm-hmm. stories and your success. I'm really happy for you and Hsing-kuo. Mm-hmm. Please keep up the good work.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. You know, you must. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you for watching, people. I'm Shirley Lin.